Can you pass the parmesan? I promise you'd cut down on that stuff.
I will.
You know, I think you should get your head examined for willingly inhaling it. Yeah, I think you might need some mental-
Help!
Shut it, you pillock!
Sir, yes, sir!
I said shut it, or I'll beat you half to death. Then I'll steal that little bag of money you've got there, and then I'll beat you half to death again, leaving you only a quarter away from death.
Go around there, save that guy, bring him back here, I'll explain when you get back.
Okay, but actually I'll be bringing them both back, I'll explain in a minute.
Come on and be my little good luck charm, hey, you sweet delight. I want a good luck charm hanging on my arm. A two-hat, a two-hope, a two-night.
Who's the little lady?
Oh, that's just Marguerite.
Hiya, Marguerite!
Yeah, I'll go and get that for you.
I like your garden, and you have a nice
water... Who did you say you were?
I'm the big man.
Why did I call you that?
Because I'm the big man.
One of many big men? What's with the? Is it your real name?
It is to you.
Well, it's a bit shit, really. Is it the best you could come up with?
Thank you. Well? Where is it then?
Margaret, could I see you for just one moment? Just one second, please. Where's the money?
What money?
The money.
What's the money?
The money I was saving. The money in the suitcase upstairs. The money I told you specifically not to touch.
I might have spent that.
On what?
Cocaine?
That was the money I owed to the big man, Margaret.
Why do you owe him anything?
He helped me out of a tight spot a few years back. That's not the point. The point is you spent it, now I'm as good as dead.
Well, how much do you owe him?
How much did you spend?
For good, then.
How are we in any way good?
Well, that's how much paranoid Patrick owes me. That's what I figured was in his little bag down there. But your friend, the big guy, or whatever his last name is, tried to steal it off him.
I have several questions.
Shoot.
Paranoid Patrick.
He's a cocaine addict. Of course he's paranoid.
What, is he Irish or something? Patrick sounds Irish.
Maybe a distant relative was.
3,000 miles is very distant for a relative.
Maybe that's not the part to focus on, Max.
Fine. But how could it possibly be the same amount of money?
Well, I buy the coke for a price. In this case, the amount of money that was in your case. Then, I take a bit out for myself and sell the rest of them at the same price. I sell it to my Patrick. Now, he owes me as much as you owe the big man. So, he gives me the money, I give you the money, you give the money to the big man. All debt is cleared. You don't need me for getting you killed. We ride off into the sunset. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Peach?
That's a complete rip-off. How do you even pull that off?
Isn't it obvious? My immense charm.
Fine, let's just go clean up your mess.
Finally finished your little chit-chat?
Yes, we find ourselves in a little predicament, gentlemen.
This little predicament needs to consist of me getting all my money without any of you pissing me off, or someone's going to find a very sharp and very metal thing sticking out the back of their face.
Well, let me explain.
What? I'm not giving you this. Are you crazy? You must be crazy. I owe this to him. If he doesn't get it, he's going to kill me.
Why do you owe him?
He helped me out in a tight spot a few...
Oh, the infamous tight spot that's claimed so many.
Wait, what's going on?
Well, we're in the shit.
He's in deeper shit.
And you, my friend, are the king of the pile of shit. We don't have your money unless he gives us our money, which is also apparently your money anyway, I think.
And Patrick, sweetie, we'll kill you as well if you don't hand that money over.
Mm-hmm. Great.
Will someone just give me some money already? My hand's a little lonely without it. Maybe he'll be satisfied with someone's disembodied jawbone in it.
Max!
Margaret!
What are you doing?
Plan B!
Hurry!
Ah!
Your turn.
Can I just go to the loo first? I'm desperate.
Fine.
But be quick, we're keeping the money until you get back.
And put the toilet seat down when you're finished.
Anything you fancy for dinner tonight?
Fish and chips.
Alright, sure. Get it.
Let's get you taped up then, shall we?
Margaret, your friends are here.
Coming. Right, Gordon?
Yeah, not too bad. Just got back from bowling.
Who's that?
Just Steve from bowling. Nothing.
What are you doing now?
We arranged the coke deal for today.
Oh, come in. Gordon, Max, Max, Gordon.
All right.
Steve, Max, Max, Steve.
Hi.
The knife's gone.
Oh, I probably just put it in the wrong drawer again, don't worry.
No, one, it's definitely missing.
Is that Margaret talking or is that the shit up your nose?
Maybe.
And replaced it with a mutilated corpse.
You've stolen my knife!
Borrowed it, actually. You killed Steve! Who's Steve?
My mate from bowling.
You killed Steve!
I think she might have lost it.
It's that damn cocaine you sell her, you prick!
It's not even cocaine. I've never even had cocaine. It's flour.
What?
What?
What? I've been selling you flour this whole time. I've never even had cocaine. Sorry.
You bastard!
Stuffed shirt like me on a tree. After I count